in our UNODA strategic plan. It's part of our gender policy. It's really part of our DNA, I would say, in UNODA. So our through this education strategy, we also make commitment to using education as an important tool to further that objective. And that goes two ways. It goes both in terms of bringing more diverse perspectives and audiences into shaping disarmament education content. So again, having diverse institutions that we work with, educators that we work with, others that we consult in terms of developing content that really reflects a diversity of experience and perspectives. And then on the other side, identifying key target groups and beneficiaries that are underrepresented in disarmament decision making, and seeing how we can use disarmament education and empowerment efforts to bring them more directly into disarmament. So that's and I mentioned already youth, I mentioned women, I mentioned the important focus on the Global South. And then the final area, I said this is kind of a theme running through our new strategy, and that is partnerships. So really trying to enhance the sustainability of disarmament education and the impact through new types of partnership and expert networks, to really use this at the global level, but also at the regional level, recognizing that experiences and requirements are quite unique from country to country, from region to region, and how can we, as ODA, use, again, our convening and connecting power to really make that a stronger focus going forward. So,
and the idea was to enhance the focus and expertise on disarmament and non-proliferation activities in Vienna to better connect the work in Vienna to the other UN disarmament and non-proliferation centers, mainly Geneva and New York. And of course, the other idea was to contribute to capacity building in Vienna through disarmament education efforts. And we are, of course, really pleased that 10 years later, both the BCDMP and the ODA office have become such an integral part of the disarmament and non-proliferation presence in Vienna. I'm also pleased that the office in Vienna has been designated, is designated as the ODA hub for disarmament education efforts for the implementation of the new disarmament education strategy, which we think is a very good development, and I welcome the new strategy as an important initiative, and of course Austria fully supports it. Colleagues, disarmament in the sort of broadest sense is a long-standing political priority for Austria. We try to be an active contributor across the wide range of disarmament and non-proliferation issues, from conventional weapons to nuclear weapons, from humanitarian disarmament to export controls.
I'm happy that we are sharing the same roots, coming from the initiative that the Austrian Federal Government put forward in 2010 at the NPT Review Conference, which launched both of our organizations. We're already celebrated 10 plus 1 anniversary. I think we were, first of all, like, do it before they change their mind, so to speak. But no, I'm kidding, of course, but it has been a real pleasure to share not only the roots, the ideas of strengthening disarmament focus here in Vienna, but also the vision and the goals of both engaging various communities, focus on education, capacity building, and educating on non-proliferation and disarmament issues. From the very early days of the establishment of your office with that, we've enjoyed a very good cooperation with it. And that, in fact, we were very happy to work with the office to develop some of the concepts and programs that became part of it, of the broader Vienna agenda. And just to give you a few examples, we, as a member, worked on designing the disarmament organizational platform, our center contributed to some of the modules that are part of it. And we're always happy to cooperate with
mentorship programs, contributing to the lectures, engagement with the scholars and young women. Always happy to host UNODA fellows here in disarmament fellows here in Vienna, but also over the years we were also tasked to bring the and organize a program for UN disarmament fellows in Brussels to familiarize them with the work of the European Union institutions and broader European community. So that has been fantastic, and we're looking forward to continuing expanding our work in this area, but also be part of your conversation series that you have particularly revived here, Rebecca. I'm very honored to have been able to host with you a conversation with a UN High Representative for Disarmament Affairs, Izumin Kamitsu, and I know many of you were attending that presentation, as well as many other events, either focus on disarmament, education, or UN 5040 resolution, and many others over the years. And I'm looking forward, I'm very excited about the new strategy and looking forward to finding our new partnership and cooperation in implementing it and contributing to it. But what I also wanted to know that education and capacity building, awareness raising have always been big part of the work of the Vienna Center for Disarmament and Nonproliferation itself. And some of the earlier guidance and inspiration came from the UN study on disarmament and nonproliferation education that we're also celebrating 20 years now from its inception. So it's also very time.
About Instagram and TikTok coming, right? But if we are trying to reach different audiences, engage different segments of population across genders, across ages, across regions, and the age is also extremely important. So as various methodologies and tools that we engage. I'm also delighted to hear about the focus on bringing other scientific communities, STEM, to work more closely. I think it's extremely important. And those of us here mostly working in the policy world, we sometimes are not doing a very good job of engaging our scientific community and speaking and understanding the same language as they do. I have had whenever I have an opportunity to engage with the STEM community, we discover that the goals and inspirations and passions are similar, but we do have different ways of looking at things. And bringing these communities together through broader engagement and education capacity building work is a must. We need to have all these communities at the table. We also need to be able, as Rebecca mentioned, to focus on different regional perspective, even national perspective, at different levels, global perspectives, and that is extremely important to tailor some of the resources to understand the way that the way they post the regional characteristics or certain circumstances work. In this regard, one of the other programs we were engaged with in the UNODA office was focused on educating individuals from Southeast Asia. And I learned quite a significant amount of the specifics. How do you approach this? What are the issues that will actually are priorities for the region first? And how do you approach it? And under what angle do you start this discussion? So,
what that means for our collective work, these are all things that really have to be also integrated into disarmament education. conversation, and that's not easy to keep that current, to keep that relevant, but we're collectively committed to doing so, so thank you both again for your kind words. I'd love to give the opportunity, if anybody wishes to ask a question or make a comment or anything, that the floor is open. I have a little video I want to share with you as well before we do the celebratory part of the event, with the support that has come from your respective institutions, and I know will continue to come as we work to implement this work. So, and I ask my colleagues to just tee up our present Aaron.
I'm really, really lucky to have such a great team of dedicated colleagues, and I want to really pay tribute to them for all the work, not just this year, year in and year out, but we've been really lucky to grow our team a bit this year. We hope to continue to do that, and I just really want to express my appreciation for what they do, and to say how fun it is also to work with them. So please just enjoy this moment of mingling and hopefully some light moments.